All right, folks, how you doing? Well, I'm back. Kind of want to give you an update. As you know, I've always been very open and transparent about, you know, dealing with anxiety, PTSD, panic attacks, all from childhood trauma of being a survivor of sexual abuse. And probably over the last 6 months and probably the last three, I felt myself getting weary again, like just holding this anxiety in over the last so many years, you know, just building up. And 4 weeks ago, I decided after about 10 years to get back and got me a good therapist from Morehouse, as I said. He's a Morehouse grad, PhD, and I'm enjoying it. But I just want to kind of share with you what I've learned. And I hope it'll be helpful for anybody who's dealing with anxiety, anybody who is a loved one of someone who deals with anxiety, panic attacks, PTSD from all kinds of trauma. I speak about the trauma of childhood sexual abuse because that's the trauma that I'm personally dealing with. And I was starting to get really weary. And when I mean weary, just tired. So I knew my body, because again, in 1992, I had a complete nervous breakdown, but I couldn't tell anybody because the business was only 4 years old, had a young family. So I just spent my whole life, since this happened to me as a 9-year-old, I've spent 55 years just pushing through the anxiety and different things. And I realized that's not a healthy way for my body over time. So Henny, I kind of want to share with you kind of what I've learned and what I'm working on to get myself to a whole new level. So this is for all those who are trying to figure out if they're dealing with any kind of, you know, anxiety issues or whatever from whatever it might be. One, you're not alone, but two, I'm just sharing what I've learned. I'm not a professional therapist or anything, so I'm just sharing to help others because I wish I'd have had someone who was sharing back in 92 and before about this. 92 is when I finally even admitted it. I had buried it that well. So anyway, a couple of things. First thing is I realized that recently I never wanted to admit how much what happened to me really impacted me. I felt like that made me weak. Of course, I always blame myself as a child, even though as a child you shouldn't, that it was my fault that I let it happen. I wasn't strong enough. So actually, I downplayed how much it really hurt, how much it was just painful that to think that happened, that someone stole my innocence like that, that I allowed myself to have a predator, you know, groom me, and then the threats. And I realized how much that threat has impacted my whole life. Next thing is, the other thing my therapist helped me with, I kept saying to myself over the years, man, don't complain, it ain't that bad or whatever, because, you know, you've been so blessed. And I was starting to feel like, you know, I'm not appreciative of my blessings. But what my therapist taught me was, you got to put the blessing of my life to the side and let myself feel what I truly feel. So for over 55 years of my 64 years of living, I kept pushing off and not letting myself and my body and mind finally kind of deal with that pain and say, yeah, it was bad. It was, and it really impacted me. So I'm kind of reading, I've made some notes because I wanted to make sure I kind of kept it, you know, concise. But, you know, also, I never let myself deal with the pain. You know, I kept putting the pain back. I wouldn't let my body deal with the pain. It's like when we fall and scratch ourselves or hurt ourselves, we have two options. We can either let ourselves heal, or we keep letting the pain or letting the scratch fester because we won't do the proper things to let it heal. But what I realized, and my therapist taught me this too, I had taken that pain and I had wrapped it up in this pretty box and I had put the box in the closet. But in reality, the pain kept leaking, and that's that anxiety and stuff. My anxiety was getting more and more to a breaking point. And what I realized was I never in all my life allowed myself to say, I'm experiencing pain. Let that pain, you know, let me work through that pain and then get rid of that pain forever. But also you only do that by doing the proper things to let it heal and admitting that you've fallen or you got a scratch. For me, it was admitting what happened to me as a child was sexual abuse and it was bad. Somebody stole my innocence and all the things that went with it. I had to stop downplaying it in my mind because that way I didn't have to deal with it like I thought. But in reality, it's been holding me back from truly, truly healing from it. I healed just enough to where I could function and I could maybe help others. But in reality, I think I was afraid to really allow myself to feel that pain. So I'm just starting that journey to where I'm going to acknowledge it. I'm going to feel it and I'm going to let it heal like anything else that hurts us. We have to let it heal. And what happened and what I realized over my lifetime, I've let this pain develop into anxiety that's gets overwhelming after years. It doesn't, for me, it's not overnight. I mean, in 1992, as I said, I had a complete breakdown, but it's taken me 28 years that I just kind of been pushing through the pain, not acknowledging the pain, and my body, with my parents dying last year, dealing with them and having to sell their house and all that. But also I realized over the last 3 or 4 years, you know, the health challenges, I had things that kind of just kept me going and pushing through this, what I had to deal with. So I think their passing also took away what I would say was a crutch of something I had to focus on was them and their health. To now, I finally had to face this, that Dave, stop being afraid to deal with what really transpired emotionally. Stop belittling like it wasn't that big of a deal and get back in therapy and finally deal with it. So we're on this journey. So I'm finally allowing myself with my therapist is face the pain of 55 years ago. Let that pain come through me and then leave me for good. And I'm on a journey. I'm going to keep you posted. I'm taking one day at a time and just being still and finally resting. I got to rest. Even though I'm doing, you know, work with the company, my business, and I got great people, so I'm able to kind of function. But right now, I'm trying to not deal with anything that creates anxiety in my life until I kind of work through where I'm trying to go through because I've never been there. But it's a great thing to realize I'm finally going to face this, what I've been kind of putting away. I just dealt with it enough to understand it, but now I got to finally deal with it at a different level. And I'm also really working on my faith, even though I've always been my faith in God and his son, Jesus, I'm trying to go to a different level of that true trust. Cause when anxiety and what happened to me as a child, I realize often I feel like I'm alone. I have to do it on my own, whatever it might be. In reality, I don't. And to all my fellow survivors, we're not alone. And to the loved ones of survivors of any kind of trauma that causes anxiety, PTSD, and panic attacks, your support is so important to us. Your patience is so important. And it's showing us unconditional love is all about. I mean, I say this all the time. I wouldn't be where I am today if it wasn't for Carla. I mean, her patience and just holding me when I need to be held and helping me navigate this. One of the reasons I got back into therapy, therapy's helpful. I hadn't been in therapy for about 10 years or so, but I needed not to wear her down and trying to navigate this. And my therapist is making me think about some things and answer some questions and finally face it. And it's so important. You know, I might be weary emotionally, but I'm so excited about the future. I'm on a journey to finally free myself of the pain I buried, but it wasn't gone. You know, I buried it, but the pain, the impact, the effects of it just kept manifesting itself because I never just kind of dealt with it. Now, after this journey, the pain will be healed like a a sore or anything else in our on our body, when we do it properly, we can heal. And that pain and whatever has hurt us, we can address it in the proper way. But one of the things I realized, I really tried to keep that pain buried versus facing it and dealing it. So anyway, I'm coming along. I'm doing well. And again, I share this because there's, you know, unfortunately, an estimated 42 million survivors of childhood sexual abuse just in the United States. Again, 1 in 10 children before the age of 18 will be sexually abused. And we have a bad habit of saying children are resilient. They are, but we forget they become adults. And even in 92, when I first kind of addressed this in private and had a breakdown, people still weren't talking about the impact childhood sexual abuse or any kind of trauma really can have on your life. And I'm just excited to share my journey because I just want to help as many people as possible. And one of the reasons I do is that I always felt bad because I never said anything about what happened to me. And I wondered, did I let that person hurt other people? And that's something else I had to deal with and release, because I felt guilty that I, as a child, because I didn't speak up, did I let him hurt other people? So anyway, I love y'all. I'm on a great mission, and we're going to fight through the fear, and we're going to get through this. So live from Moodyville, I'm hope to have some new guests soon, but I'm on an exciting journey that I'm finally going to deal with anxiety and the pain from my childhood in a whole different level, to finally, hopefully, free myself completely of the pain. I'll never free myself of the memories. I'll never free myself of what happened, but I finally got to face that pain and not let anxiety just have so much impact on my life. Take care. Love you. And everything's great. And I'm so excited about the future. And got some great opportunities coming, but I'm really excited about the young folks in the company who are really stepping up and making things happen. And, you know, I pray to God that he gives me the opportunity to lead them to a whole new level. But more importantly, I just want to keep helping other people who feel all alone. And I just want you to know you're not. Take care. And sorry, this was a little long, a little bit over 12 minutes, but I just wanted to share where I am and what's going on. And hopefully it's helping somebody. Take care. Peace.